the food pantry became part of the Recreation Community Services Department in 2009. Before that, it was run very informally out of the welfare department of the township. It was basically, it started as a metal cabinet where residents can come and go before or after business hours. If they needed food, they were able to help themselves to the food. It became a little bit more formalized when it became under the umbrella of the Recreation Community Services Department. That was in 2009. To start, what we did was Cindy Capriti, who was the first food pantry clerk when it became under the Recreation Community Services Department, went over and visited the South Brunswick food pantry. So ours is modeled after the South Brunswick food pantry. At that point, we established an application, also a food grocery list that the recipients would need. So instead of just packing bags at whim, we actually asked the recipients what they need. They fill out a list, and that's part of the application, and then we fill the bags to their needs, not just, like I said, on a whim. We also have to ask for proof that they need this kind of, that they're eligible, so that they need, that they're in actual need. So that's all part of the process. So that was established all at the same time. Also, volunteer recruitment and how we were going to get food into the food pantry. So at that time, they decided to go to churches, scout groups. They all run food drives for us. Currently, we still do that. Also, they established a 10-month, 10 schools program. So each school, for the 10 months that school's in, they do a food drive. And that's how we fill the food pantry with food. Also, we went out and got corporation donations. So we always accept cash donations or donations from corporations. And then we go and fill the shelves for things that are, we may be depleted in. So if the food drives don't get the exact food, or not just foods like diapers, that kind of stuff, we also accept at the food pantry. So we will fill in the void with our own purchases. So we'll go out and purchase what is needed. So that's the history of the food pantry. Rhea Benaroff, who is the food pantry clerk currently, has really taken it and continued on the path that we were at the very beginning, and has expanded the way that we get food from the different sources, as well as really increasing the volunteerism that we have. We have plenty of volunteers that bag the food for our distributions, and also stock the shelves. We actually have to go in and date everything that we get, because we don't want anything that's expired. So they will actually, the volunteers are set to come in and date all the cans, stock the shelves, and then bag the groceries for distribution. Food pantry recipients are Plainsboro residents. That is a must, and they have to meet HUD guidelines. HUD stands for Housing and Urban Development. So they set a criteria each year for low-income families. So they have to meet the low-income HUD guidelines to be a recipient. We also will allow, if they're under any other government-subsidized program, we allow them to be a recipient. We're not trying to make this difficult for people. If people are in need, we want to be able to help them. So it's not difficult, but we do have to have some kind of criteria. The number of families, it fluctuates from year to year. It definitely fluctuates. But right now, we are at an all-time high. We have over 50 families that are food pantry recipients and are receiving food from the food pantry. You can go on www.plainsboronj.com, go under Recreation Community Services, and then Food Pantry, and then there's actually a flyer of what we will accept. And we update it, because sometimes we have an abundance of one thing and needs for the other. But for the most part, it's unexpired, non-perishable items. But we do accept diapers and those kind of things. But they're all listed there. So for me to go into it, you know, when you can go to our website and get information on other programs as well. But we also, we've moved our food distribution to Thursdays, the second and fourth Thursdays of the month, because we now go on Wednesdays to McFoods. McFoods stands for Middlesex County Food Pantry, and they actually have fruits and vegetables. So it makes sense for us to pick that up on Wednesday and give out the distribution on Thursday. We used to have our distribution Tuesday, but now we're able to offer a little bit healthier choices for them with some fresh produce, which is great. Also, once a month, we get donation from Sunny D, which is a beverage company. So once a month, we'll go to Sunny D and pick up beverages so that we can also include that into the food pantry. The other things that we do with the food pantry is we have a holiday wishes, and with the holidays right around the corner, holiday wishes is a program where we set up three trees. We have a tree here in our building, Recreation Cultural Center, in the municipal building, in the library, and our recipients will fill out wish lists, and we tag the trees, and then anybody from companies to, you know, other residents can take a wish and then fulfill that wish and bring the gifts in here. So that time of year, we also will accept, you know, toys and gifts and that kind of stuff. So we try to merge the two together, which is really nice. Food pantry is located in the municipal building, which is across the plaza from where we're sitting now in the Recreation and Cultural Center. It's on the ground floor, which is 641 Plainsboro Road. Like I said, it's in the municipal building on the ground floor. If you walk in the building, make a right, and the food pantry is right there on the left. So that's where we store the food and we distribute the food. We always looking for volunteers for the food pantry as well as all of our programs. Again, go to the website, fill out the application, stop in here and see us if you're interested in volunteering. We have plenty of volunteer opportunities for young and old alike, but the food pantry is always in need. We can never have too many volunteers. If residents are interested in donating food, just an individual family wants to donate food, you could always stop here at the Recreation and Cultural Center. We're here Monday through Friday, 8:30 to 4:30. If you do happen to come after hours, you can enter through the police building at where the food pantry is at 641 Plainsboro in the municipal building. And there's a box outside that you can just leave it there. And it would be greatly appreciated. So we do anything we can to make it as convenient as possible. So during working hours, you can drop them right here at the Recreation Cultural Center or right in front of the food pantry. And after hours, the same thing, just right in front of the food pantry door.